going on, Cubs fam? We are back for another Disney Sorcerer's Arena video. I am super excited for this one because when you start a game like this, and I know a lot of you guys are starting this game, it just launched last week, the question quickly becomes, who do I farm first? There's so many new characters here, I don't have a good grip on how good these characters are. Who should I farm? Well, look no farther than the graphic that I've got here for you today. This is from our man, Asteld, who is going to give us a very solid look at which characters we want to start farming in Disney Sorcerer's Arena. Big thanks to him for putting this together. I endorse all of these. A lot of these characters I have been seeing. I've been kind of taking this advice and doing this, and it's been working very, very well for me. So this comes from him and several experts in this game who've been playing the game since beta launch, which was about a year ago. And so there's actually a lot of history for some of these guys in the game. So just want to kind of call that out. So let's start with this. We're going to start with our starting heroes in the game. You're going to have Mickey, Ariel, Buzz Lightyear, Aladdin, and Sully. Now, I want to call Sully out right away. Sully is a very good tank at the beginning of the game. He still feels pretty good to me. Like, he annoys the heck out of me when I go against him in live PvP. But from every indicator I have received from endgame players, he sucks in the endgame. He's not going to be usable for very long. So you're going to have a pretty short shelf life on your Sully. Sorry, Monsters, Inc. fans. Hopefully we get a rework or something when they bring in Mike Wazowski. Am I right? Aladdin, very good. Buzz Lightyear, shelf life. Ariel, very good leadership, but she's going to be replaced by someone. And Mickey, top tier character in this game, at least top two tiers, somewhere around there, even in the end game. So very solid, worth investing in. Gaston, Captain Hook, Syndrome, Demana, and Yzma are going to be your next five for villains. So that can help get you through the villains campaign. You're going to replace them with some characters pretty soon, especially, Captain Hook, or Yzma especially. You're going to want to replace her ASAP. She's just not that good, especially in the end game. But there's some characters you want to replace there that we'll talk about here momentarily. All right, now your starting heroes team that you're going to want to go for you're going to want to replace Buzz Lightyear, and you're going to want to replace Ariel and Sully with the Genie, Jasmine, and Shan Yu. Now, this team is very good. It's easy to farm. You can get Shan Yu in the tournament store. You got the Genie. He's going to be able to clone himself, which is great. He's also going to be able to save a teammate when they die. And then Jasmine has some great synergy with Aladdin. She's going to function as your tank. She can call Raja into play. Raja doesn't go, he goes down kind of quick, but it's just that little extra distraction is very good, and she's going to have an assist with Aladdin automatically. I called him Adam, I guess. This team has a lot of good turn meter control. Aladdin can do so on his AoE, his carpet ride. I just call it the carpet ride. And then Shan Yu, bonus turn meter on his leadership ability. Very good damage. One of the best characters in this game. He's probably in the top four best characters in the game. And so that's going to be the first heroes team you're going to want to go for. I know Shan Yu is not a hero, but he's just going to be he's going to be really fantastic in that team. So you'll need to replace him, obviously, for the heroes campaign, but these are going to be five to go for very early on. Villains wise, Jangles, very good tank. And then you've got the Big Bad Wolf. Believe it or not, this 1930s cartoon character is one of the highest damage dealing characters in the game. I am very, very happy about my investment in Big Bad Wolf. Now, I don't know if highest damage dealing is a fair statement for the end game, but where I'm at right now, his AoE is stupid good. It's so dope. I love the Big Bad Wolf. Probably my favorite character that I've unlocked so far. Very good damage from Big Bad Wolf. Syndrome, Demana, and Dr. Facilier. I don't know much about him at this point, but he does work very good in a villains team. You're going to be able to take advantage of these guys for the Zerg event, and Zerg is maybe the best character in the game. Very, very solid. They're required for the Scrooge event, which is your gold, so that's great. Downtown villains. And then you got solid synergy, lots of debuffs, passive healing, and a very high damage potential, of course, which I already mentioned from the Big Bad Wolf. Now, so I did fail to mention with Kingdom Heroes plus Shan Yu is they're going to work for the Jafar event as well, which is something that you want to keep in mind. Aladdin, Genie, and Jasmine are going to be the three that you need there. So let's talk about the stores in this game. You've got several stores that you're going to want to focus on your farming. Let me move my webcam down just a bit. We're going to talk about all of these. Who should you focus on in each store? Now, I want to call out, too, we're going to have an exclamation point or a star next to these characters. The exclamation point means just unlock them and then gear them up. That's going to be enough for now. The star is going to indicate that we need to star these characters up for some event. There's going to be some kind of star gate that you need to get through to go for specific events. And so, let's start with our tournament exchange. We have got Shanyu in there, and Mordu and Hades. Shanyu, Mordu, and Hades, those three are probably all in the top four. The top tier of this game is probably Shanyu, Mordu, Hades, and Zerg right now. And so those three are in there. Now, the order you're probably going to want to do that in is Shanyu first, then Mordu, then Hades. Mordu, I don't think it is heavily disputed here that Mordu is the best tank in this game. He's a tank that deals good damage. Just absolutely disgusting. Every time I go against Mordu, I frankly, depending on the day, I might just put it on auto and accept a loss right now because I don't have Mordu. Mordu is stupid good, especially with Shanyu. So go for Shanyu first. Then Mordu and Hades, again, get all those unlocked. Big Bad Wolf, Dr. Facilier, I keep calling him Mr. Dr. Facilier and Jangles, you're gonna star them up for events, so that's something to keep in mind. But heavy focus there on... right now, I am giving every single tournament exchange token I've got to Shanyu and then Mordu. That's myself. Big Bad Wolf, Jangles, and Dr. Facilier. I know Big Bad Wolf for sure is available in other locations. I'm pretty sure the others are as well. All right, let's talk about Club Exchange. You get pretty good tokens on this, so you should be able to be a little bit more liberal in who you're buying here. Jack Sparrow, very solid. And just pay attention to how often that store resets because Club Exchange doesn't give you a ton of shards per purchase, and so just get him unlocked. Mickey, you're gonna want to get him farmed up for events. Syndrome as well, and Demona, and then of course there's gear there. You can totally farm gear pretty liberally there. I'm doing that. I'm buying a lot of gear from this. I think usually they come in. You can get two at a time, and so that's gonna be very helpful early on. All right, let's move on to the Heroes campaign. Here's who you're gonna want to farm: Big Bad Wolf. Can't overstate it, especially in the early game. Big Bad Wolf took my squad up very high on how solid it was. And so I am super, super happy with the investment on Big Bad Wolf. Jangles, again, very good tank. You're going to want Jangles. Jangles, just get him unlocked. And then we got Demona here. You're going to want to farm her up for the Zerg event especially. That's going to be kind of where you're going to want to have those stars taken care of. All right, let's get rid of the webcam so we can see the rest of the graphic here. I'm just going to give you guys full screen here. We have got the Villains campaign next. So we're going to talk about Villains and Grand Campaign. For the Villains, you're going to want to farm Jasmine. You're going to farm... basically, you're going to get ready for the Jafar event, ladies and gentlemen. You've got Jasmine, Genie, and Aladdin. And I would recommend... You can see the nodes that they're available on. I would just recommend mostly farming those that you're farthest away from. So Aladdin, you're going to want to start him up, of course. Genie and Jasmine enough for Jafar. If you've got Jasmine and Aladdin, focus on Genie, etc. So I'm focusing on Genie right now for where I'm at. I do not have Genie unlocked just yet. And then next up, rounding this thing out, we've got the Grand Campaign. You're going to want Syndrome. You're going to want Big Bad Wolf. You're going to want Dr. Facilier. And so that's where all of those are available too. And so that's a big reason why for Tournament Exchange, I definitely recommend going for Shanyu and Mordu first. And then focusing on Big Bad Wolf, maybe Dr. Facilier after that. You can get Syndrome. You can get Syndrome also from Club Exchange. And so Syndrome, to me, a little bit lower priority for my arena team right now. However, having him for the Zerg event can't be understated. Zerg is just absolutely disgusting, so you're going to want to have him. A couple other characters to talk about that you're going to want to focus on. Once you get there, it's going to take you a while to get there to farm. Let's see here. What's her name? Hops from what's the movie? Zootopia. I should know this because I've got her in my roster. She's super good. The rabbit. Also from Brave, you've got Merida, Judy Hopps is the name. Thanks. I'm filming this on Twitch live right now. The chat's helping me out. I don't know. I forgot Judy Hopps. I've said her name like 1,000 times because I got her in a pack. If that pack ever comes back and you are a spender, I would absolutely recommend grabbing that. I was able to get her unlocked for that purpose, which is great. I'm using her in my arena team now. She's at gear 4. Meredith's great too. She's got a pretty cool mechanic where she gets these wisps that follow her around. Once you get 4 of them, it charges up the rest of her ability. Super, super good. But Judy Hopps especially, really good damage. She's got 2 AoEs. One that's a chain attack. It can do between 2 and 4 hits. Deals a lot of good damage. And then she chucks a donut, which is a full AoE. Very, very good damage on that too. Tends to be, at least. And she's a quick character. She looks a bit like a bit of a spaz too, especially if you get on 3x speed. Very good. So focus on all of these characters, ladies and gentlemen. Don't bite off more than you can chew. I would definitely recommend at least starting with these heroes, moving towards Shan Yu and Mordu as soon as you can. If you're going to take anything from this video, Shan Yu and Mordu are going to be, they're the two characters I want the most right now. They make a massive, massive, massive difference in that live PvP. And to my knowledge, live PvP is kind of where this game is at. At least that's where it feels like it's at. To me, it's where I personally am having the most fun by far. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining me for this video. I hope this was helpful for you. Again, big W in the chat for Azteld for providing this graphic for us. I think it's a really easy money, easy comprehensive way to look at farming in this game. And I have personally greatly benefited so far from focusing down these characters to start with. So let me know what you guys are working on down in the comments below. How do you guys feel about this game? And if you're new here, please consider hitting subscribe. I would very much love to have you as part of the Cubs fam. Thank you very much for joining me for the video, my friends. And as always, my brothers, don't forget